whenever we fill in the toroidal space in a toroid by magnetic material, the medium which is present at the center is called core, C-O-R-E, core, that is medium which is present inside the toroidal region of a toroid. And if that medium has permeability mu, then total magnetic induction in that magnetic material is given by this formula, mu Ni. If inside the toroidal region there is a vacuum, we would write here mu 0 Ni. But instead of vacuum, if there is some magnetic core, then we write here mu. Okay, so the formula is B equals to mu Ni. What is relative permeability? Mu r equals to mu upon mu 0. Mu upon
mu 0.
Find out mu. It is mu r into mu 0. Mu r into
mu 0.
What is small n? Number of turns per unit length of circumference of a toroid. Number of turns per unit length of circumference of a toroid. That is total number of turns which are wound on the circumference of a toroid divided by total length of circumference of a toroid. That will be 2 pi r, come on, I as it is. Now tell me, this is total magnetic induction and how much it is they given? 2.5 tesla. Value of mu 0, permeability of vacuum, 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 tesla meter upon ampere. Relative permeability we want, total number of turns they give 3000, 2 pi as it is. What is r? Average radius of a toroid. Say average
radius of a toroid.
Average means what? Inner radius plus outer radius divided by 2. Inner radius is 11 cm, outer radius is 12 cm. 11 plus 12, that is 23 upon 2. Answer is 11.5 cm. But here we should write that it is in meter. 11.5 cm convert into meter. Multiply that as to minus 7. This current they have given 0.7 ampere. Simplify, find out value of mu r. This coming out to be 685. 685. And suppose they ask magnetic susceptibility, then don't you know mu r equals to 1 plus chi m. So chi m will be mu r minus 1. Mu r. So this minus 1, it will be 684. 684. Got it? Next. Look, maximum magnetization, sometimes we call it complete magnetization, correct? Complete or maximum. It is number of magnetic dipoles per unit volume multiplied by magnetic dipole moment per one magnetic dipole. Number of magnetic dipoles per unit volume, they are given 2 into 10 raised to 26, and magnetic dipole moment of one dipole, they are given 1.5 into 10 raised to 23 ampere into meter square. This answer is 3000 ampere upon meter. Ampere upon meter is the unit of magnetization. Let us find out now mod of U maximum. What is U formula? Capital U equals to minus MV cos theta. Minus MV
cos theta.
When you take modulus, from minus will become plus. So it is MV cos theta. MV
cos theta.
And when you are adding maximum, cos theta you should take equal to 1. So now it is MV. What is magnetic dipole moment of one dipole? 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 23 ampere into meter square. This magnetic field, they have applied how much? 3 tesla. This answer is 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 23. Unit of energy would be joule. What about average kinetic energy? You know it is average of 1 by 2 mv square. Studied in second semester, average of 1 by 2 mv square equals to 3 by 2 kt. K or kb you may write. This is Boltzmann's constant. Boltzmann's constant. Now 3 by 2 is 1.5. Boltzmann's constant is 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 joule upon molecule into Kelvin. This is absolute temperature. You must write in only into Kelvin. The given temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, 27 plus 273, altogether it will be 300 Kelvin. Simplify, answer is 621 into 10 raised to minus 23 joule. Now remember, if this value is equal to this or this value is greater than this, then complete magnetization is obtained. I repeat, if this is equal to or greater than this, come on, this is equal to or greater than this, complete magnetization is obtained. But here, this is, come on, greater than this. Or you may say this is less than this, this is less than this. At present, mod of U maximum, it is less than average kinetic energy. It's less than average kinetic energy. Okay? Because this is less than this, then complete magnetization will not be obtained. Will not be obtained. Okay? Next. We have two magnets, bar magnets, which are short one, and they are kept in the same plane with their axis being perpendicular to each other. Magnetic axis of this magnet is vertical, magnetic axis of this magnet is horizontal. Horizontal and vertical, so they are mutually perpendicular. Both of them are to be treated as short magnets. For a short magnet, tell me, what is the magnetic field on the equator? Mu 0 m upon 4 pi y cube. Instead of y, suppose I am taking b, okay? On the axis, what is the magnetic field? 2 mu 0 m upon 4 pi z cube. Instead of z, suppose it is d. Now you can see, mu 0 m upon 4 pi d cube can be replaced by b. So this much part can be replaced by b. So it is 2 into b, 2 into b. Right? So we should use this result. Magnetic field on axis on the far axial point is double than, come on, magnetic field on the equatorial point if the considered points are at the same distance from the midpoint of the bar magnet. Look, these are the centers of the two magnets, this and this, okay? This is a line segment joining their centers, and that total distance I am just taking 2d. So half of that will be d and d, okay? This total distance, they are given 2 meter. So half of that will be 2 upon 2, that is 1 meter. So d is 1 meter, fine. Now at this very point, we are asked to find out magnitude of resultant magnetic field. First of all, take this as magnet number 1, take this as magnet number 2. This is the point which is situated on the equatorial line of first magnet. Why? This is magnetic axis. And this is perpendicular bisector. And any point on a perpendicular bisector is located on the magnetic equatorial line. For this point, because it is located on the equatorial line, you know magnetic field will be opposite to magnetic dipole moment. Opposite to magnetic dipole moment. Here it is from south to north, this way, correct? And opposite to this, it will be like this. Correct? But let it be B1 because of magnet number 1. At the same point, because the same point is located on the axis of second magnet, their magnetic field will be double than this because distances are equal. Distances are equal. If you take z, of course, also equal to d. If you take y, also equal to d. Then distances you are taking equal. Then magnetic field on axis is, come on, double than magnetic field on equator. So come on. Here, magnetic field due to this far magnet will be in the direction of magnetic dipole moment. At any point on the axis, come on, magnetic field direction is same as direction of magnetic dipole moment. Here, dipole moment is from south to north pole, it is this way. In the same direction, this magnetic field exists. Now, this is because of second magnet, I am just showing the symbol B2. It is double than this, so B2 equals to 2B1. B2 equals to 2B1. Fine. Now, find out B1. B1, because it is the point on equator of first magnet, come on equator, what is the formula? mu 0 m upon 4 pi by q. Instead of y, I am putting b, correct? Come on, beta equals to 2 mu 0 m upon 4 pi z cube. Instead of z, I am putting d. Instead of z, I am putting d. Now, this mu 0 m upon 4 pi d cube can be replaced by b1. So, if you replace this part by b1, then it's 2 into b1. Come on, 2 into b1. At point q, one magnetic field is this way. One magnetic field is this way. Then you can see they are at right angles. The angle between them is 90 degree, and because they are at right angles, the resultant magnetic field will be along hypotenuse. And what about magnitude of hypotenuse according to Pythagoras theorem? Come on, square root of summation of squares of two mutually perpendicular sides. So BDS will be, come on, under root of B1 square plus B2 square. You may find out from here also. Look, in this direction there will be resultant magnetic field, right? Let it be B dash. Then B dash will be, come on, under root of B1 square plus B2 square. Come on, B dash will be under root of B1 square plus B2 square. What is B2 square from here? B2 square will be 4 B1 square. B2 square is 4 B1 square. Write it here. B2 square is 4 B1 square. 4 B1 square plus B1 square, that is 5 B1 square, its square root will be, come on, root 5 into B1, root 5, root 5 into B1, B1 is how much? Mu 0 M upon 4 pi d cube, mu 0 M upon 4 pi d cube. Root 5 as it is, come on, mu 0 value everybody knows, 4 pi into 10 to the 7 tesla meter upon ampere, that is permeability of vacuum. What about magnetic dipole moment of one dipole, one bar magnet, they will 1 ampere into meter square, 4 pi as it is. What about this distance d? Total distance was 2 meter and half of that will be d equal to 1 meter. D equals to 1 meter. Simplify, answer is root 5 into 10 to the 7. Unit of magnetic field is tesla. Right? You please remember this is that b dash equals to root 5 into magnetic field on the equatorial point. On the equator. This is the magnetic field on the equatorial point. Okay? Next. We have a bar magnet whose magnetic length is given to us 5 cm. So 2L is 5, then L will be 5 by 2, that is 2.5 cm. On its magnetic axis, we have one monopole, north pole. We have one magnetic monopole in the form of north pole, whose pole strength is different than pole strength of this bar magnet. Here pole strength is different, here pole strength is different, remember. Now this is the midpoint of bar magnet and this is the location of, come on, magnetic monopole. And this distance they are given as 20 cm. Now tell me, if this is north pole and this also is north pole, so this north pole will repel this north pole this way, okay? So this is the magnetic force exerted on this. Magnetic force on a magnetic pole, what is it? Pole strength into magnetic field. Pole strength into magnetic field. But because this is the point on the axis, I have written here magnetic field BA, A for axis, okay? Fine. Now for bar magnet, let us find out magnetic dipole moment. It is pole strength into magnetic length. Pole strength, I am taking B, magnetic length is 2L. B is how much? B for bar magnet, they give how much? 200 ampere into meter, correct? What about magnetic length? 5 cm convert into meter. Answer is 10. Unit of magnetic dipole moment, come on, ampere into meter square. Now, this magnetic field produced on the axis will provide magnetic force on this magnetic pole. And let that force be F. You know magnetic force on a pole, it is pole strength into magnetic field. Pole strength into magnetic field. This pole strength is different than this pole strength. Then here I am giving symbol P. Here I am giving symbol P dash. Into BA. B dash as it is, what about BA? General formula for magnetic field on axis of a bar magnet, what was that? 2 mu 0 mz upon 4 pi into z square minus z square whole square. Let us place all the values. This is the pole strength of the north pole and you are given that 100 ampere into meter. 2 as it is, what about mu 0? 4 pi into 10 to the minus 7 Tesla meter upon ampere. What about magnetic dipole moment of the bar magnet? 10 ampere meter square. 10 ampere meter square. What about distance Z? You are given, come on, 20 centimeter. 20 upon 100, that is 0.2 meter. 4 pi as it is. What about distance Z? Come on, 20 upon 100, that is 0.2 meter. And what about L? L is how much? 2.5 centimeter. Divide by 100, 2.5 upon 100, that is 0.024 meter. It's a square and then whole square, okay? Simplify, answer is 2.579 into 10 raised to minus 2, that many newton. In textbook, what is answer? You know what have they done? You know what have they done? They have neglected this L in comparison with Z. You cannot neglect that L. Why? If the value to be neglected in comparison with the total value, if it is 1 or 2% of the total value, you may neglect it, correct? But right now, what is the value to be neglected? 2.5, right? They have neglected in textbook. In comparison with 20, 2.5 is not 1 or 2% of this. 2.5 is exactly 12.5% of this. You can find out that. 2.5 into 100 upon 20. 2.5 into 100 upon 20. 2.5 into 100 upon 20. How much it is? Exactly 12.5%. Now the value to be neglected, if it is 1 or 2% of the total value, you may neglect it. No problem. 1 or 2%. But 12.5% value, that cannot be neglected. So you must consider it. You must consider it. Okay? And they have not used anywhere. Have they used the word short magnet? Have they used the word short magnet, small magnet? No. So you must not neglect this length. You must consider it. Okay? And then answer is 2.579 into 10 minus 2, that many newton. Next. What is work done formula? MV into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Work done in case, in the first case, let it be W1. You know, the in the first condition, the magnet is lying in the magnetic meridian. Whether it is mentioned or not, you must take it granted by default. It is lying in the stable equilibrium condition. In the for stable equilibrium condition, come on, theta 1 is 0 degree. And from that condition, you just rotate it by angle 90 degree. Okay, so this theta 2 is 90 degree. Come on, cos 90 is 0. Cos 0 is 1. 1 into MV, that is MV. Now in the second case, let it be W2 equals to MV into, come on, cos theta 1 dash minus cos theta 2 dash. Again, you have to start from the same initial condition that was stable equilibrium condition for which theta 1 is, come on, 0 degree. But now this is the new angle. From that stable equilibrium condition, you rotate the magnet by just 60 degree in the second case. So this angle is now 60 degree. Come on, cos 0 is 1, cos 60 is sine 30 is 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2 into MV, that is MV by 2. Now work done in first case, they have given in the statement N times work done in second case. W1 is how much? Right now it is MV. And W2 is how much? MV by 2. W1 is MB, W2 is MB by 2. Come on, MB, MB will cancel. And transfer this 2 here, so N equals to 2. N equals to 2. Simple. Next. In the true magnetic meridian, come on, tan phi equals to BB upon BH. How is magnetic meridian? It is a vertical plane. Anna? Now, instead of that true magnetic meridian, if you take another plane as a vertical plane, it is wrong magnetic meridian. But in that wrong magnetic meridian, BB remains constant. BB remains constant. Instead of BH, you should write now, come on, BH cos alpha. BH, what is alpha? Angle between given vertical plane and true magnetic meridian. Angle between given vertical plane and true magnetic meridian. That angle is alpha. And instead of true deep angle 5, you will get now wrong deep angle, that is B5, 1. Wherever it is BB upon BH, I can write 10 further. So here it is, BB upon BH is here, okay? So in place of this BB upon BH, I can write 10.5 cos alpha as it is. And now, this wrong deep angle, you are given 45 degree. True deep angle we want, cos alpha, alpha you are given 30 degree. Now tangent of 45 degree is 1, transfer this. So 10.5 equals to cos 30 degree. Cos 30 degree or sin 60 degree, they are equal, it is root 3 by 2, it is 0.866. So in textbook what have they done? After finding this 10.5 equals to 0.866, they have simply written 5 equals to, come on, transfer this. So 5 equals to 10 inverse of 0.866. But in the school examination, they may ask, even in the final also, they may ask this deep angle in degree and minute. In degree and minute. Find out in the table of natural tangents. The nearest value to 0.866, you will get 0.8662. 0.8662. Exactly at what? 40 degree, 54 minutes. Anna? So this is the true deep angle, 40 degree, 54 minutes. Read next. Look, V equals to R omega, omega come on 2 pi m. Angular frequency is frequency multiplied by 2 pi radian. Frequency multiplied by 2 pi radian. Find out f from here. It will be V upon 2 pi r. F equals to V upon 2 pi r. I equals to f into q, where q is a charge which is circulating. Right now it is 1 electron, so I should write, instead of q, I should write e. And you place the value of F, I mean formula of F, is V upon 2 pi R. Come on, F is V upon 2 pi R. Now what about magnetic dipole moment? NIA, NIA. Number of turns you take 1, I formula is VE upon 2 pi R. I formula is VE upon 2 pi R. This is the, come on, area of 1 turn, which is area of 1 circle, and it is pi into radius square. Pi, pi will cancel, R also getting cancelled. Now it is V E R upon 2. V E R upon 2. Come on, V. Orbital speed they are given, come on, 2 into 10 associated meter per second. Magnet of charge of 1 electron, 1.6 in raised by 19 coulomb. Then what about small r? That is orbital radius, 5.3 into 11 meter divided by 2. Answer is 8.48 into 24. You are finding magnetic dipole moment. Unit is ampere into meter square. Then orbital angular momentum given by this formula MVR. Where M is mass of 1 electron, 9.1 in French mass circular kilogram. Orbital speed is 2 into 10 to 6 meter per second. Orbital radius is 5.3 into 10 to mass 11 meter. Answer is 9.65 into 10 to mass 35. Come on, unit of angular momentum, it is joule into second. Say, if it is linear momentum, it is newton into second. Linear momentum then?
Newton into second.
And angular momentum then? Joule into second. Look, Newton's second law. Come on, vector F because of vector dp by dt. Correct? So what is unit of linear momentum? Transfer this. Force into time. Say,
force into
that is newton into second. Say, similarly, you had also studied vector tau equals to, come on, vector dl by dt, vector dl by dt. So what is angular momentum? You just transfer this, torque into time, say,
torque into time.
Force into time is known as impulse of force. Torque into time is known as impulse of torque. It is as good as change in angular momentum. It will have unit joule into second, say,
joule
into second. Magnetic field on axis is given by this formula, 2 mu 0 m upon 4 pi z cube. Mind well, this formula is applicable only when you neglect this L, correct? When you can neglect this L? provided the given magnetism is a short magnet or you are taking far axial point, then you can neglect L and you will get this formula. This magnetic field on axis, you are given 10 raised to minus 4 Tesla, 2 as it is, mu 0 value everybody knows. Magnetic dipole moment we are looking for, 4 pi as it is. Distance you are given 10 cm, converting to meter, 10 upon 100, there is 0.1 meter, cube of it. Simplify, find out value of M, comes out to be 0.5. Unit of magnetic dipole moment, come on, ampere into meter square. And now we want magnetic field on the equatorial point, mu 0 M upon 4 pi by cube. Mu 0 value 4 pi into 10 minus 7 tesla meter upon ampere. Magnetic dipole moment recently we have found out 0.5 into 0.5 ampere meter square. 4 pi as it is. Distance is still the same on equator also. Come on, 10 centimeter, 10 upon 100 is 0.1 meter. And now cube of it. Simplify, answer is 5 into 10 minus 5. Unit of magnetic field is tesla. Next. Maximum magnetization, it is N upon V into M. Look, what is this? Number of magnetic dipoles per unit volume multiplied by magnetic dipole moment of one dipole. If you take the unit, what is the unit of V here? Ampere into meter square. Ampere into unit of volume is meter cube. Ampere into meter square upon meter cube. Ampere upon meter. That is the unit of magnetization. Now we want total magnetic dipole moment, that is N into M. We want, make it subject of the equation, transfer this B. That is M maximum into B. This is the volume of given magnetic substance and it is given to you in the form of a cylinder for which volume is how much? How much? Pi R square H. Pi R square H. M maximum. M maximum. Come on. How much? Maximum magnetization, how much? Pi to N is to 3 ampere upon meter. Pi value written, come on, radius. I think diameter they have given 2 centimeters. So radius will be 1 centimeter, 1 upon 100, 0.01 meter, square of it. What about length? 5 centimeter, 5 upon 100, that is 0.05 meter. Simplify, you are finding total magnetic dipole moment. It will be having unit ampere into meter square. Next. For electron, let me find out total kinetic energy of all the electrons. It is number of electrons multiplied by average kinetic energy for one electron. Just divide on both the sides by total volume. Okay, I just divide by V. This is number of electrons per unit volume. You are given 5 into 10 to 21. This is average kinetic energy for one electron. Come on, 6 into 10 raised to minus 20. Answer is 300. You are finding energy upon volume, so it is joule upon meter cube. Similarly for ions, let it be Ki equals to Ni into average of Ki. This is total kinetic energy of all the ions. This is number of total number of ions multiplied by average kinetic energy per one ion. Come on. This is, I'm just dividing on both the sides by V, okay? So this number of ions per unit volume, we are given, come on, 5 into 10 to 21. This is average kinetic energy of ion. Come on, 8 into 10 to 21. Answer is 40. You are finding energy upon volume, joule upon meter. Now, as I said here, for obtaining complete magnetization, this should be equal to this. Minimum value of this should be equal to this. This may be greater than this. Okay. Right now, we are taking this equal to this. That is modulus of maximum magnetostatic potential energy, we just take it equal to total kinetic energy. Total, why total? Because there are two particles, come on, electrons also are there, ions are also there. And formula of this, it is M into B, instead of M, I'm just putting MB, that is induced magnetic dipole moment multiplied by strength of magnetic field. Come on, this is KT means what? KE plus KI. I just divide on both the sides by V. just divide by V, okay? That is total volume of the given substance. Now, induced magnet dipole moment per unit volume, it is nothing but magnetization. So instead of MB upon B, I am just putting capital M, this capital B as it is, KE upon V as it is, KI upon B as it is. This applied magnetic field, they given 1 Tesla, KE upon V, we have the value with us, KE upon V is how much? 3 mm. What about KI upon P? It is 40. This is 40. 300 plus 40, that is 340. You are finding M, that is magnetization. From here, if you are finding, already it is Joule upon meter cube divided by Tesla. Look here, Joule upon meter cube divided by Tesla. And this is Joule into Tesla inverse into meter raised to minus 3. But this is as good as ampere upon meter because ultimately you are finding magnetization. You are finding
magnetization.
Look. Joule upon Tesla. What is Joule? Newton into meter. Tesla is as good as Newton upon ampere into meter. Newton into meter will cancel. This will go. So it is ampere into meter square. And now Joule upon Tesla. This is Joule upon Tesla. Divide by meter cube on both the sides. Divide by meter cube on both the sides. And when you divide by meter cube here, it will be ampere upon. Okay. So these two are equal. Better look here only. This is magnetization. As long as it is this is magnetization, yeah, the unit has to be equal to come on and get upon meter. Next. Total number of turns divided by total magnetic length. Find out N, transfer this, N into 2L. Number of turns per unit length, they are given 10 turns per 1 centimeter, convert into meter. Magnetic length, they are given 6 centimeter, convert into meter. 10 raised to minus 2 will cancel. 6 into 10, that is 60. Okay. Straight also you can write down. This you are given, this N value you are given, look, 10 turn per centimeter. And this is how much? 6 centimeter. Okay? Centimeter, centimeter will cancel. 6 into 10, that is 60 turn. Come on. This is a magnetic dipole moment of a solenoid. By formula, it is NIA. You know current carrying solenoid, current carrying loop, they are equivalent. We had used this formula, NIA. Very weird use this formula. NIA. Come on, M equals to NIA. Anywhere? Number 3. Here it is. See, current carrying loop and current carrying solenoid, they both behave like bar magnet. Then the formula remains same, NIA. Come on, number of turns, it is come on 60. What about current? Current they give 1 ampere. What about area, cross section of a solenoid or area of one turn, they are given 3 into 10 minus 4 meter square. Simplify, answer is 0.018 ampere into meter square. Then you know magnetic dipole moment is nothing but pole strength into magnetic length. We want now pole strength for solenoid, transfer this. So it is Ms upon 2L. Ms is 0.018, magnetic length 6 cm, curve into meter, answer is 0.3. You are finding pole strength, unit is ampere into meter, ampere into meter. Current carrying solenoid, current carrying loop and bar magnet, all the three are equivalent. Okay.